The method feeder is one of my favorite ways to catch carp, tench, and bream. And in this simple method feeder kit, I've packaged up everything you need to start this type of fishing. And this video is gonna be all about what's in there and how to get the most out of it. So what do you get inside this kit? First of all, there's a box. This is for mixing up ground bait and storing your bait in. Within that, a leaflet with some beautiful pictures drawn by my lovely girlfriend, Omi, and instructions as to how to fish the method feeder and use all the items inside this kit. Then we've got ready tied rigs, enough to last you absolutely ages. A spool of line, that's what you can put on your reel. There's 1,000 meters here, which, to be honest, is overkill, but you can never have enough line. Then there's the method feeders themselves. I have packaged this up with plenty of feeders of different sizes and weights so you can cast the right distances. I'll get into more details about the feeders later. There's also molds for both sizes. This is for attaching bait to the feeder, making sure it's aerodynamic and neat and it casts really well. Then there's some basic essentials, a baiting needle, some scissors, some speed beads. This is what you will use to set up your rig, and a disgorger to unhook the fish that you're hopefully going to go and catch. As well as that, I've also put some hook baits. These are wafters, perfect hook baits for carp and tench. I've also caught bream on them as well, but primarily those are a carp bait for me. And then 2 bags of bait, 1 kilo of pellets and 1 kilo of ground bait, giving you plenty of bait to do a number of sessions. This is probably going to last you, well, it depends how many fish you catch, I suppose.
Oh, you're joking.
Oh dear. Oh, after all that, brought it all the way in, it fell off. Before you actually go fishing, you're going to want to put the line onto your fishing reel. To do this, take the spool provided. This is 8-pound line, perfect all-round strength for method feeder fishing. Drop it into a bucket of water. Then take your line, run it through the first eye of the rod, open the bail arm on your reel and tie the line onto the spool. It doesn't really matter what knot you tie because it's going to sit at the bottom of the spool anyway. Then begin reeling the line onto your reel under a little bit of tension, maybe through your fingers or through a wet cloth. If you notice a little bit of twist in the line that's sort of coming onto the reel, just flip the spool over within the bucket. One way or the other will spool up perfectly without any twist. I like to fill the spool almost to the top, maybe leaving about 1 millimeter before the lip. If you put too much line onto your reel, you're just gonna have tangles because it will all spring off and casting will become more difficult. Leave a little gap between the top of the line and the lip and you'll be just fine. If you'd like more details about spooling up, getting the right amount of line on your reel and what lines to use, there's a link in the description to a full spooling up tutorial, which may be of help. Either way, now your line is on your reel, you're pretty much ready to go fishing. Tying up rigs used to be a little bit complicated and took a little while to learn, but I've made it really simple with this kit. I've provided ready tied rigs, which are very easy to just loop on and start fishing with. All you'll need to do is take your method feeder, pull the little provided swivel out, we don't need this, and thread your main line through the feeder. Once you've gone through it, then take the speed bead. It's got 2 parts, a rubber part and a metal swivel. Slide the plastic part onto your line before tying on the swivel. The knot that I like to use is a half blood knot, very easy knot to tie. All you need to do is go through the eye, round and round and round the line as you go back on yourself. Do that about 7 times, 7 or 8 times is normally enough, and then pass it back through the sort of hole that you've created next to the swivel. Wet it down a little bit, tighten it down slowly, give it a good pull to check that it's bedded down right, and you're good to go. If you do struggle with knots and you want more detail on that knot or any others, I've also linked the knots that you're gonna need in the description underneath this video, where I run through the knots a little bit slower and a little bit easier to follow. Once you've done that, you can then take one of these ready tied rigs, pop it out of the packaging and loop the loop over the crook of the swivel. It's a little sort of quick change type swivel. You hook it over the top, pull the plastic of the speed bead down until it clicks, and your rig is locked in place. You're ready to fish. If at any time in the day you want to change hook links, maybe it's damaged or the hook's gone blunt, or you just want to change bait, you can very easily pull that speed bead apart, loop off, and then loop back on another rig. Now, on the topic of bait, I've provided two bags in this kit. One bag of pellets and one bag of ground bait. Both will work just fine on the method feeder, but some people have certain preferences based on what venue they're fishing or what fish they're trying to catch. Personally, I find ground bait is my number one. However, sometimes you fish somewhere with lots of roach or rudd in it, very small fish that will nibble up the ground bait too quickly. It's in that case where I'd rather use pellets because they last a bit longer, they're a bit more resilient, and they'll stick around until the carp move in and start feeding. Mixing these two baits is a little bit different. With ground bait, all you want to do is chuck some ground bait into a bucket and sprinkle water onto it slowly, mixing it thoroughly in between. What you want to do is you want to keep adding water until it gets to a consistency where you can squeeze it into a nice hard ball, but rubbing it between your hands, it sort of dissolves back into a powder again. If you put too much water in, it'll get sloppy and it will never dissolve off of the feeder. If you make it too dry, it'll probably fall off of the feeder when you're trying to make a cast. Now with pellets, I like to put them in the bottom of the tub, completely cover them in water so they're completely submerged, leave them there for about a minute before draining all that water off. Then if you wait 15, 20 minutes later, that water will have gone inside the pellets, would have made them nice and soft and sticky, and they'll be ready to use on the feeder. Both baits, as the day goes on, especially if it's hot and sunny, they might dry out a little bit. You might want to just splash a little bit of water onto them to moisten them up a bit more, make sure they keep sticking to the feeder well. But that normally only happens on very hot sunny days. Now you're pretty much ready to cast out. It's just time to load up your feeder. The aim here is to create the perfect little parcel of food with your hook bait right in the middle of it. So when the fish come in and start feeding on the ground bait or pellets, bang, they find your hook bait and get caught. The way that you make this really neat, aerodynamic, and cast really well is to take the method mold, lay your hook bait into the bottom of the mold, sprinkle some ground bait or pellets on top, make a little mound, then press your feeder down into that. You want to give it a good firm press so that the bait doesn't fall off on the cast. Then flip it over, push on the back, and it will release your ready loaded feeder. You can also load a feeder by hand if you're in a hurry. It's actually probably just as easy to just squish the ground bait onto the feeder with your palm, but the method mold makes a really neat aerodynamic package that will cast better and more accurately. As you go through your session, it really pays to cast accurately, or at least as accurately as you can. Each time you make that cast, you're introducing a little handful of food. So if you plop it all over the place and they're never really landing in the same place, you're spreading the food out, you're breaking the shoal up. Whereas if you keep landing it consistently in the same place, the fish are gonna become more concentrated in that one area and you'll get quicker bites as a result. The way I cast accurately is to pick a marker on the far side. So I'll go with like a tree or a post or something that's not gonna move. And I know that I need to line up with that every time I cast out. Then I put the line in the line clip. Basically, that means I can cast, the line will peel off until, bam, it hits the clip and the feeder will fall down the same distance every time. Sometimes people ask me, well, like, what if I hook a big fish and it's pulling loads of line and it gets to the clip and I can't give any more line? Well, in that situation, helps to stay calm, open the bail arm up, lean forward to, you know, get a little bit of slack and then release the line from the clip. It might not go totally smoothly the first time you do it, but trust me, once you've figured that out, you will never have an issue. And to be honest, most of the time when you catch fish on the method feeder, they run a little bit at first, but normally you're absolutely fine. And I very rarely have to unclip the line from the reel during the fight. For most of my method feeder fishing, I will use one of two hook baits, sweet corn, or these little 8mm wafters. Most of the time, I will use corn. It's just an unbelievably good bait that I've caught fish everywhere I've gone with. Like, it's so reliable. They fish just love eating sweet corn. But if you're fishing somewhere with lots of small fish, sometimes because the corn's a little bit soft, they can sort of nibble it off the hook. That can get a bit frustrating, and that's why I've included these wafters in the kit. These are much more resilient and will stay on your rig much, much longer than a bit of sweet corn will. So you've got options. Attaching these baits to your rig couldn't be more simple. The sweet corn, because it's soft, you can use what's called a speed stop. Some of the rigs that I've provided in this kit have got speed stops on them. Basically, you take that, you take your needle, you push the needle into the end of the speed stop, slide on your grain of corn, pop the stop off the end, turn it 90 degrees, and your bait's locked in place. It holds the bait on really well, and it means the hook is always completely exposed, ready to hook into a fish when it takes the bait. It's much better doing that than putting the corn straight onto the hook, because quite often the hook can be covered by the grain and you'll miss bites. Alternatively, if you want to use the dumbbells, like the little wafters, they're a bit firmer and you're best off mounting those with what's called a bayonet. This is a small metal spike, and all you do is you take your bait, press it onto the end, give it a little twist, and it will lock in place, and that will stay on for absolutely ages. So those are the rigs that are provided and the baits that I like to use and how to mount them. When I'm setting up in my swim, I like to position my chair and my bank sticks so that my rod is approximately 45 degrees from the spot that I'm fishing. I'll cast out in front or wherever, and then I'll put the rod on the bank sticks at that angle so that when a fish takes the bait, the rod tip will pull round and I can see visually on the rod tip a bite being indicated. What you tend to find when method feeder fishing is you get lots of little knocks and bumps on the rod tip. This is because fish are coming down, they're feeding on your pellets or your ground bait. They might not have found your hook bait yet, but they're nudging your feeder and they're sort of trying to eat all your food that's out there. When they're doing that, sometimes the rod tip will just tap or wobble, like when the fish brush the feeder or the line. Do not strike. If you just start striking at all of that, you're just going to scare the fish away quite often and you'll waste a lot of time and you have to keep recasting. It's a bit annoying. The best thing to do is wait. Wait until that rod confidently pulls round and keeps pulling round, or wait until the rod tip just goes dead straight, springs back, and the line falls slack. If that happens, pick up, reel down, and you'll either be into a fish or you'll just need to make a recast. When you're picking a fishing rod to use for method feeder, anything that's sort of sold as a feeder rod with a quiver tip is probably going to be just fine. I like a rod tip with a test curve of maybe 1.5 ounces to 2 ounces. Some quiver tips are super delicate, and they're under an ounce, and it's very easy to snap those rod tips. You don't really need that for method feeder. You want something a little bit stiffer just because you're casting regularly. And to be honest, the bites on this method are pretty confident. It's not easy to miss them. So you don't need a super sensitive rod tip for method feeder fishing. Got him. Oh, that's lovely, that. Beautiful carp caught on the method feeder. All being well and you're catching a few fish, you might find every now and then you get one that's a little bit deep hooked. They're all barbless hooks in this kit, so they're very easy to remove, but if it is a bit further down, you want to use a disgorger. I've put one of these in the kit because they are absolutely essential for any type of coarse fishing. To use it, you just apply a little bit of tension on the line. You don't have to pull hard, just enough tension to sort of make the line straight. Slip the line into the slit on the disgorger and slide it down under a little bit of tension all the way to the hook. Give it a little press and twist to the left. If it doesn't come out, another little press and twist to the right. In one direction or the other, that hook will come straight out and that little disgorger has saved the day. If this video has helped you, I am very, very grateful. And if this kit gets you out catching fish on the method feeder, then even better. If you've got any more questions, feel free to check out the leaflet that's included within the kit, or stick a comment down below and I'll do my best to get back to you. Good luck with your fishing this year, whether you've got the kit or not, whatever you're fishing for, wherever you're going, hope you catch loads. Thanks for watching. See ya.